Hi everyone, I hope you're good. This is Sharik and welcome back to Globetrot with Arabic. As usual, this is going to be a Lebanese Arabic lesson, which means it's a Levantine Arabic lesson. Levantine is the language spoken in Lebanon, Jordan, Palestine and Syria. And under the same category falls the Lebanese dialect. So yalla, last time we began a lesson, a short passage on a stormy day in London. So today we're going to continue this passage. We just did the half until here. And now I'm going to continue it. Yalla, before people join, I want to let you know that I run 30-day Lebanese challenge courses. These are pre-recorded courses. And there are levels all the way from absolute beginners to advanced. And what's different about these courses in comparison to the YouTube lessons is that these are very, very structured courses. They have like a roadmap that leads you from one point to another, which means if you're serious about learning Arabic and spoken Arabic specifically, this is a great chance because it gives you a push. It gives you a motivation to do a 30-day challenge. It comes with recorded live videos, recorded notes with my voice, lots of PDF files that you can print, and lots of audio material that you can use to study even outside of class. Okay? So yalla, let's begin. I'm gonna start as usual by reading fast. Whoever is in, let me know if the voice, if the sound is good. Yalla. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. اليوم في, remember, I am not reading slow here, yeah? اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. الهوى برا كتير قوي بيطير زلمة كرمال هيك مزروبة بالبيت مع انه كان عبالي اظهر شوي وغير جو بس معلي اوقات الزربة بالبيت مفيدة رتبت البيت اشتغلت مع تلميذة وصورت فيديوهات صغار على تيك توك من بعدها تغديت شوربة لوبيا وبندورة انا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي بس خلصت معها تلفنت لأمي وبيي بلبنان وعملنا فيديو كول مع بعض شكله بكرة الطقس رح يكون نفس الشي يعني يمكن انزرب بالبيت مرة تانية بس إذا تحسن الطقس بظهر شوي وبشوف أصحابي هلأ بس خلص معكن بركي بعمل جات بوشار بحضر فيلم وبنظم حالي لبكرة انتو شو عملتوا اليوم؟ كتبولي بالتعليقات. Guys, just give me a second. The delivery is here. I'm just gonna drop the box and come back. One second. Okay guys, I'm back. So I just dropped the parcel and came back. Yalla. Okay, now I'm gonna... So for part one, as I said, we did it last time. So go watch part one and then you can come do part two. We did up until here. Yalla, so here I'm gonna start breaking things down from this part. بس خلصت معا. When I finished with her, بس خلصت مع. So here you can use بس or لما. نفس الشي صح؟ يعني when I finished with her. لما خلصت مع. بس خلصت مع. خلصت يعني I finished مع يعني with her. بس خلصت معه when I finished with her. تلفنت. I have to give you a fun expression here because I can barely breathe. You can say عم بتنفس. I'm breathing. عم بتنفس من طيزي, from my butt. Which means I can barely breathe. عم بتنفس من طيزي. It's a fun expression to use. So, يلا. لما خلصت معه, when I finished with her, تلفنت لأمي. I called for my mom. Notice the la here, yeah? In Arabic, that's how you say it. تلفنت لأمي. ما فينا نقول تلفنت أمي غلط, okay? تلفنت لأمي. تلفنت لأمي وبيي. I called for my mom and dad, which means I called my mom and dad, بلبنان. بلبنان. Notice here, I can pronounce it بلبنان أو with a سكون بلبنان. نفس الشيء, تنانيتون نفس الشيء. It's just sometimes when I'm speaking fast, of course, I end up pronouncing it with a سكون. So, تلفنت لأمي وبيي بلبنان. I called my mom and dad in Lebanon. وعملنا فيديو كول مع بعض. And we did. عملنا فيديو كول, video call, مع بعض. With each other, يعني together. عملنا يعني we did. عملنا فيديو كول مع بعض. شكله بكرة الطقس رح يكون نفس الشيء. شكله, شو يعني شكل؟ شكل literally يعني shape of something. So but when you say شكله, you don't mean to say his shape or its shape. شو يعني؟ مين بيعرف شو يعني شكله؟ Who knows what does it mean شكله؟ شكل يعني appearance or shape. شكله يعني you're saying it seems, it looks like. Okay? شكله, it seems that. So memorize it as a phrase. شكله. When you want to use it to talk about a situation and not about people like it seems or she seems or he seems, you always use it with the masculine form. شكله. Okay? شكله بكرة الطقس. Tomorrow, the weather. بكرة الطقس. رح يكون, will be. رح يكون, will be. نفس الشيء, same thing, the same, will be the same. So شكله بكرة الطقس رح يكون نفس الشيء. It looks like the weather tomorrow will be the same. And it's true, in fact, it was the same when I wrote this the next day. يعني يمكن انزرب, يمكن انزرب. If you watched part one last time, we spoke about the adjective مزروب أو مزروبة, يعني when you're stuck at home, right? The verb of this participle is أنا بنزرب. أنا بنزرب. I get stuck at home. So يمكن انزرب. Maybe I get stuck at home. Okay, not necessarily at home, but you get stuck. Now, ليه ما منقول يمكن بنزرب؟ لا, غلط. ما منقول يمكن بنزرب. ليش؟ لأنه we have to remove the B. لازم نشيل الB. من بعد يمكن, after يمكن. Okay, مثلا يمكن بنزرب, maybe I get stuck, غلط, يمكن انزرب. فيني اقول يمكن بروح, لا, يمكن روح, maybe I go. Okay, so we have to drop the be after يمكن. يعني يمكن انزرب بالبيت, maybe I get stuck in the house, يعني at home, مرة تانية, another time, but you're literally saying مرة time, تاني, second, another, a second time. Okay, so خليني عيد من هون. بس خلصت معا, when I finished with her, تلفنت لأمي وبيي, I called my mom and dad, وعملنا video call مع بعض, and we did a video call together. شكله بكرة الطقس رح يكون نفس الشي. It seems like the weather tomorrow will be the same. يعني يمكن انزرب بالبيت مرة تانية. يعني maybe I get stuck in the house another time. بس شو يعني بس؟ يعني but in this case. بس but إذا تحسن الطقس. إذا تحسن الطقس. تحسن يعني gets better. إذا تحسن الطقس, if the weather gets better. بس, but, إذا تحسن الطقس, if the weather gets better. Notice here we used تحسن in the past because it's a conditional. إذا تحسن الطقس, if the weather got better, which translates as if the weather gets better, and then you do the rest, okay? So, but it's if you say بس إذا بيتحسن الطقس, it wouldn't be wrong in the Lebanese dialect, okay? You can use both. إذا تحسن الطقس, that's the past. وإذا بيتحسن الطقس, كمان it's okay to say. Okay? إذا بيتحسن الطقس, بظهر شوي, بظهر يعني I go out, شوي, a bit. بظهر شوي, وبشوف أصحابي, and I see أصحاب يعني friends, أصحابي يعني my friends. Guys, remember, whenever we're doing this together, always make sure you're saying things out loud all the time, like a parrot with me, because that's how you learn a language, okay? And also at the same time, make sure you're taking notes and you are even writing this passage when we finish, okay? Maybe type it in the comment box later on, okay? So, بس إذا تحسن الطقس, بس if the weather got better, gets better, بظهر شوي, I go out a bit, وبشوف أصحابي, and I see my friends. هلأ, now, بس خلص معكن, بس خلص معكن. What can I put instead of بس here? يلا, write it in the chat box. بس خلص معكن, when I finish with you, plural معكن. بس خلص معكن, شو؟ شو فيني أقول بدل بس? What can I say instead of بس? يلا, I will wait. I'm not gonna give you the answer. There are 12 people in here, so one of you should know the answer. بس خلص معكن أو شو? ما رح أقول. I'm not gonna say. ما رح ألكن. مين بيعرف? أنا ناطرة. I'm waiting. أنا ناطرة. I'm literally saying I am the person who waits or the waiter, which means I'm waiting. أنا ناطرة. شو? ما حدا رح يقول. I know YouTube is slow sometimes. YouTube بطيء شوي. So يلا قلولي. شو فيني أقول بدل? بس خلص معكن. When I finish with you. لما. صح. برافو ناتاسا. لما خلص معكن. نفس الشي. Okay, so لما خلص معكن, when I finish with you, plural, بركي بعمل جات بشار. بركي, we said it in a previous lesson, maybe a couple of lessons before. نفس المعنى, مثل يمكن, same meaning as يمكن. Okay, يمكن بعمل جات بشار. Okay, so يمكن بعمل, maybe I do, جات, يعني a bowl of, جات بشار. Okay. Now here, after يمكن or after بركي, also you can drop the ب. يمكن أعمل. There is a, I just discovered something like a hidden meaning. It's not black and white, okay? But I'm just gonna explain it to you. If I say يمكن بعمل جات بشار or يمكن أعمل جات بشار, what's that hidden difference that I sense here? So when you say يمكن بعمل أو بركي بعمل جات بشار, it's like you're still thinking about it and you're kind of maybe talking to yourself and you're saying to someone, I might do this. But when you say يمكن أعمل جات بشار, you're just saying you still didn't decide, but you might do it. You might do a بشار. بشار يعني popcorn, by the way. جات بشار يعني a bowl of popcorn. So the one that's with the ب, يمكن بعمل or بركي بعمل, you're still in the process of thinking about it and analyzing, maybe I do it or maybe I don't do it. You're talking to yourself. Again, it's not black and white, okay? I have a feeling it's like that. But when you say بركي أعمل جات بشار, يعني you're not sure, you might do it. But it's not like you're thinking about it right now, okay? But you can use them interchangeably. Don't go too much into these details. يعني I'm just speaking out loud here, okay? So هلا بس خلص معكن. Now when I finish with you, plural معكن, بركي أعمل أو بركي بعمل جات بشار. Maybe I do a bowl of popcorn. بحضر فيلم. I watch a movie. بحضر مش بحضر. I prepare. So شوفوا الفرق. أنا بحضر. I watch. أنا بحضر, I prepare. This is something I have to repeat so many times with my students because almost everyone gets confused with this. بحضر يعني I prepare. بحضر. بحضر, I watch. بحضر فيلم, I watch a movie. وبنظم حالي لبكرة. بنظم يعني I organize. بنظم حالي I organize myself. بنظم حالي لبكرة I organize myself for tomorrow لبكرة. Okay? So بركي بعمل جات بشار وبحضر فيلم وبنظم حالي لبكرة. وانتو and you plural. شو عملتو اليوم؟ What did you do today? So notice in Arabic we don't have auxiliaries. I'm just saying what you did, you plural did, عملتو اليوم, today. Okay? If I'm asking a guy, I say شو عملت اليوم. If I'm asking a girl, I say شو عملتي اليوم. Okay? So وانتو شو عملتو اليوم؟ Sorry, I had zoomed in too much and the Roman alphabet wasn't showing. شو عملتو اليوم؟ كتبولي, كتبولي بالتعليقات. كتبو. Look at this. كتبو. كت. It's not كتبو. مش كتبو. لا. كت. كلكن قولوا معي. All of you say with me. كت. كت. One syllable. كت. كت. Now say كتبو. 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 You plural write. That's an imperative verb. كتبو. Write. Okay. بالمؤنث in the feminine منقول كتبي. كتبي. شفتوا؟ There's a سكون on the calf. كت. And the كسرة under the ت. كتبي. وبالمذكر in the masculine منقول كتوب. كتوب. So كتبو. كتبي. كتوب. بس look what happened here. I said كتبولي. كتبولي. Write for me. Something I want to give you in terms of pronunciation, especially when it comes to Lebanese Arabic. Whenever we have the waw at the end of your word, we end up pronouncing it most of the times as a O, not U like standard Arabic. So باللبناني ما منقول كتبو, منقول كتبو, O, with the O sound. When it's at the end. But here with لي, when we added the لي, your wow, it's not, it's no more at the end of the word. That's why you don't say كتبولي. It, you go back to pronouncing it as a U, كتبولي. So لحالة on its own, it's كتبو, O. But with لي, with it, it's كتبولي, O sound, okay? كتبولي, كتبولي, you plural write for me. And masculine, it's كتبلي. And in the feminine, it's كتبيلي. In the masculine, it's not كتوب plus لي, you have to drop the wow. It's كتبلي, كتبلي, write for me. كتبلي, بي, ال, but together it becomes bit, بالتعليقات. So it's not بالتعليقات. Together there's a shadda here. بالتعليقات. تعلي يعني comment. تعليقات يعني comments. بالتعليقات يعني in the comments. كتبولي بالتعليقات. Write for me in the comments. يلا الولد. Each one of you writes for me one thing that you did today. Just one thing. كتبولي شغلة واحدة. شغلة واحدة يعني one thing. شغلة واحدة عملتوها اليوم. كتبولي بالcomments هلا. بالعربي أكيد. Of course in Arabic. كتبولي شو عملتو اليوم. أوكي. يلا رح أرجع أقرأ المقطع كله. I will read the whole passage. أوكي. رو معي. Read with me. وبنفس الوقت at the same time كتبوا جملة واحدة. Write one sentence عن حيلا شي, عن about anything you did today. Okay? يلا let's repeat the whole thing. If you want guys, grab your phone, record my voice now that I'm saying it so you can listen to it tomorrow, maybe while you're cycling, on the train, on the tube, whatever you are. Okay? اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. اليوم في عاصفة بلندن. الهوى برا كتير قوي بيطير زلمة كرمال هيك مزروبة بالبيت مع انه كان عبالي اظهر شوي وغير جو بس معلي اوقات الزربة بالبيت مفيدة رتبت البيت اشتغلت مع تلاميذي وصورت فيديوهات صغار على تيك توك من بعدها تغديت شوربة لوبيا وبندورة أنا وعم بحكي مع بنت عمتي This was part one. اليوم عملنا part two. بس خلصت معه تلفنت لأمي وبيي بلبنان وعملنا فيديو كول مع بعض. شكله برا الطقس رح يكون نفس الشي. يعني يمكن انزرب بالبيت مرة تانية. بس إذا تحسن الطقس بظهر شوي وبشوف أصحابي. هلأ بس خلص معكن بركة أو يمكن بعمل جات بوشار بحضر فيلم وبنظم حالي لبكرة. وإنتو شو عملتو اليوم؟ اكتبولي بالتعليقات. يلا قلوا لي حدا يقول لي شو عملتوا اليوم. ما حدا نعمل شيء ولا تعليق. No comment, nothing. I thought now when I open this I will see some people write something what you did today. شو حدا بده يقول لي let me wait just one minute. رح انطر دقيقة قبل ما اقول باي. يلا حدا يقول لي شو عمل اليوم. Somebody tell me what you did today. So wake me up when it's all over. My favorite sentence when I'm waiting. Students. Shoo guys. طب خلص ما حدا بده يحكي معي. No one wants to speak to me. Oh, والله Natasha. This good Natasha is here today. اليوم حضرت مسلسلات على Netflix. حلو. Nice. شو حضرتي؟ What did you watch? مسلسل عربي أو مسلسل بالإنجليزي. So look what she wrote. She said, اليوم حضرت مسلسلات. مسلسل يعني series. مسلسلات يعني series in the plural. اليوم حضرت مسلسلات على Netflix. On Netflix. That's what she wrote. And notice how she wrote اليوم with a lam, ye, wow, mean. And this is not right. It's not wrong. هذا الشيء مش غلط. Why? Because there is no right and wrong way of writing in the Lebanese dialect. So, whereas Catherine, hi Catherine, she wrote اليوم with an alif lam. Okay? So both are correct. If you write with an alif lam اليوم, you would be writing more closer to standard Arabic, but pronouncing it the same way, اليوم. But if you write it اليوم without an alif, like Natasha did, it means you're writing the way you're pronouncing things in the Lebanese dialect, which is something we do. There's no standard way of writing the language, okay? Nice to hear from you, Catherine. طيب, guys, يلا. إن شاء الله تكونوا انبسطتوا بالدرس. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. يلا, before I go, I want to remind you that if you're interested in learning the language, learning to speak Arabic with more structure and grasp everything like you know, as like someone spoon feeding you from A to Z, the perfect thing to do is to do the 30-day challenge, because it gives you a great push. You have lifetime access to these lessons, and the material you get in those courses is incredible. Like, you get tons of audio material and PDF files. And Hugo, اليوم انا روح الشغلة. روح is in the present. Hugo, you have to say, لازم تقول اليوم رحت. Okay, انا اليوم رحت. I'll write it for you. رحت. Okay, انا اليوم رحت ع شغلي. Okay, you go. يلا, we always use رحت ع. You go ع a place. طيب guys, يلا, انا انبسطت شفتكم. I'm happy to see you, ورح شوفكم قريبا, يمكن بكرة, maybe tomorrow. Yalla, bye. Bye.